Hello students, I hope you all are fine. Students, today's session we are going to learn about polynomials. And in previous session we have discussed about algebraic expression. We learned a statement connecting variables and constant by operation of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division is called an algebraic expression. So what is polynomials? Let's see. Polynomial. Some particular types of algebraic expressions are called polynomial expression or polynomial. For example, 5, 8x, a square minus b square, next 3x minus 5y plus z. These are polynomial expression, right? Okay, now we study the classification of polynomial. The first one is monomials. What is monomials? An expression consists of a single term is called a monomials expression or simply monomials because they consist of a one term. Okay, for example, 5x square, next term 7xy, next x cubes. All these are consist of one term. Now second one is compound expressions. An expression containing more than one term is called a compound expression. For example, binomial, trinomials are compound expressions. What is binomial expression? Binomial. A compound expression of two terms is called a binomial expression or simply binomial. For example, x plus y, next 3a minus 4b, next x square minus y square. So students, you can see here we have three expressions. And first expression have two terms, it means it consists of two terms. Second consists of two terms and third also consists of two terms. So it is called binomial. Now the trinomials. A compound expression of three terms is called trinomial expression or simply trinomial. For example, x square plus 2xy minus y square. Next, a plus b minus 5 are trinomials. So students, you can see these expression consist of three terms. First term plus second term minus third term, and this one is also consist of three terms. So this is called trinomials. Now we start exercise 3.2 and page number 40. Question number 1 is, add the following through horizontal and vertical method. The first one is x and x. So vertical method. First we will solve by vertical method. So first we will put the heading of solution, then rewrite the question, x plus x. Vertical method like column method. So first we will write the first term and then down second term. Now we have x plus x. Actually we add the coefficient. So you can see there is no coefficient. If there is no coefficient, it means coefficient is 1. So here coefficient is 1. And 1. So 1 plus 1, 2. And variable as it is. So answer is 2x. Now we solve this question by horizontal method. Horizontal method like row method. So we have first heading of solution and then rewrite the question. X plus x. So we will put the coefficient in bracket. So again you can see coefficient, there is no coefficient, it means coefficient is 1 plus 1, and outside the bracket write the variable one time. So 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and variable as it. So you can see by both method answer is same. Okay, now question number 1 and it's part 9. And question is 10 x square and y square. Next, minus 9 x square and y square. First, by vertical method we solve it. Heading of solution and write in column wise because it is vertical method. So first 10 x square y square, then down minus 9 x square and y square. Okay, we are adding, but C sign, its sign is plus and its sign is minus. So plus into minus is equal to minus. So 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. So we don't write 1. If there is no 1, it's understood here is 1. X square variable as it and y square as it is. Okay, so answer is x square and y square. Okay, now we solve this question by horizontal method. Okay, first heading of solution, then rewrite the question. Now put the coefficient in bracket. So first coefficient is 10 and the second coefficient is minus 9 and variables are outside the bracket. So 10 minus 9 is equal to 1. So no need to write 1. X square y square as it is. Is that clear, students? Okay. So students, your homework is exercise 3.2, page number 40 and question number 1 to 15. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15.